Hi guys, Yoshi Monika here. In this video, we're exploring the pectoralis major. We will talk about the anatomy and function of the muscle. And along the way, we give you several push-up variations for you to try and to play with. And we talk about Chaturanga, the yoga push-up, which is an essential yoga pose you can find in almost every single yoga class. So whether you're a trainer or a yoga instructor or a fitness enthusiast, you will get something out of this video. The pectoralis major is a large fan-shaped muscle which is located in front of our ribcage, the anterior part of our thorax. And being one of the most powerful muscles of the upper body, it covers most of the chest wall. The pectoralis major has two distinct muscle heads, the clavicular head and the sternocostal head. But sometimes we also mention a third part, the abdominal head. But we will talk about this in a moment. The origin of the top part of the pectoralis major, the clavicular head, is on the anterior surface of the clavicle, so in front of our collarbone, and to be even more specific, only on the medial half of this bone. The sternocostal head, the bigger portion of the pectoralis major, originates on the anterior surface of the sternum and the costal cartilages of the ribs 1 to 6, as well as the upper neurosis of the external obliques. With the attachments on the sternum and the costal cartilages of the ribs, we have two kinds of attachments. A superficial origin on the sternum, which you can see on your body, and underneath, a deeper origin on the cartilages of the ribs, as well as the upper neurosis of the external obliques, which is not visible. Now, going back to the abdominal head of the pectoralis major, the origin is the bottom part of the sternum, the cartilage of the seventh rib and part of its bone, and again the upper neurosis of the external obliques. But because we often don't see a clear separation between the middle part and the abdominal part, we usually simply add it to the sternocostal portion. Talking about the insertion of the pectoralis major, all three parts of the pecs converge to form a flat tendon that's approximately like 2 inches in diameter, which then inserts into the lateral lip of the intertubercular groove of the humerus. Now, an interesting fact about the insertion of the muscle at the humerus is that the part that originates superiorly, so in this case the clavicular head, inserts on the lower part of the intertubercular groove, whereas the origin of the inferior, so the lower part of the muscle, the abdominal head, and parts of the sternocostal head, insert onto the upper part of that lateral lip. So there is a crossing over of muscle fibers close to the insertion, which looks like a handheld fan. Now let's talk about the actions. The heads of the pectoralis major actually do slightly different things. The action of the clavicular head is a shoulder flexion and moving the humerus forward and up. The sternocostal head performs a shoulder extension, a lateral flexion, sometimes also called a horizontal adduction, for example when we do dumbbell flies or bench press. The last part, the abdominal head, helps to bring the humerus back from a flexed position, for example when the arms are overhead, when we do dumbbell pullovers or freestyle swimming or tennis. All parts of the pectoralis major help to pull the arms towards the body and with that create an adduction. All three parts together also create a medial or internal rotation. So when we look at the overall actions of the pectoralis major, the muscle performs a lateral flexion, a shoulder flexion, an adduction, and a medial rotation. When you're looking for strength and power, there's not much that beats a push-up. It's the only upper body exercise you can do anytime and anywhere. You work all the muscles of the chest as well as the shoulders and triceps, and it requires good core strength to keep the upper body stable. So let me show you some of our favorite push-up variations you can do at home, in the gym, or in the park. And just saying, once you can do 12 to 15 reps, move on to the next variation. Our number one, a supported push-up with your knees on the floor and, if you like, hands on a block. It's great for beginners, it takes off some of the body weight and with that makes this variation a great way to start building upper body strength. Number two, the standard push-up we all know. Place your hands just a little wider than shoulder width apart. Keep your body in a straight line from your head to your heels. And as you lower, keep your elbows at a 45 to 60 degree angle. And if you like a modification, put your hands on a block. And just in between, Monica will explain Chaturanga, the yoga push-up, in the next sequence, so keep watching. Number three, inclined and declined push-ups. Sometimes it's just fun to play with a basic push-up, and the difference between the two, inclined push-ups are slightly easier than standard push-ups, while declined are a bit harder because they force you to lift more of your body weight. Number four, push-up with T rotation. In this variation, alternately twisting and raising your arms after each rep forces your core to work harder to stabilize your body. And again, if you prefer a modification, use blocks. Number five, clap push-ups. With this variation, you increase the difficulty. When you push up explosively after each rep to clap your hands, you recruit more fast twitch muscle fibers, which leads to greater size and more strength gains. Number six, banded push-ups. If you're looking for a challenge, use a resistance band. This takes your standard push-up to the next level and makes it a more effective workout. Just make sure to keep your band tight across your back. Number seven, archer push-ups. Also known as side-to-side push-ups, are kind of single-arm push-ups that allow you to train one side of the chest and one arm with greater focus and intensity. Archer push-ups are already a tough exercise, but if you're ready to increase the intensity, place your feet on an elevated surface. Now, number eight, the yoga push-up or Chaturanga Dandasana gets a special treatment. Monica will explain what makes Chaturanga unique and how yogis do it.
Now let's talk about the yoga push-up or Chaturanga Dandasana in Sanskrit, which literally translates into four-limbed staff pose. Now on the surface, it may look like a regular push-up, but there are some distinct differences I want to talk about and also how you can avoid the most common mistakes. So if you want to follow along, come to a plank pose with the shoulders directly over the wrists, the feet hip-width distance apart and your body in one straight line. Pull the shoulders away from the ears, let the shoulder blades float on the back, keep the abs tight, tuck the tailbone slightly under and engage the quads. And if you want to work with the energy lines, send the heels towards the back and the crown of the head forward. Now the goal in Chaturanga is to keep the elbows directly over the wrists. And in order to achieve that, you need to shift the weight of your body slightly forward. So shift the weight forward and on your next exhale, bend the elbows and lower yourself down into Chaturanga Dandasana. Now here you have the two main differences between a regular push-up and a yoga push-up. In a yoga push-up, you exhale on the way down, and in a regular push-up, you exhale on the way up. And the second big difference is the positioning of the elbows. In a regular push-up, the elbows are at a 45 to 60 degree angle to the body. And in a yoga push-up, the elbows are close to the body and hug the ribcage. So before you go try your next Chaturanga Dandasana, let me point out a few common mistakes that I see quite often. Number one, shoulder positioning. I see quite a lot of people round their shoulders or let them drop down too much, which puts a lot of pressure on the shoulder joint. So make sure that the shoulders stay in line with the elbows are at a 90 degree angle, and the upper arms stay parallel to the floor. Number two, head positioning. Keep the head and neck in line with the spine and don't let the head drop. Number three, hip positioning. Don't pike your hips like in a downward facing dog or sag them like in a suspension bridge. Usually, Chaturanga Dandasana is used as a transition into an upward facing dog, but you can also use it in your next workout to work on your pecs and triceps.